Well, if it seems like there are more generations today than ever before, that's because there are. The span of a generation actually has been contracting. If you look at the baby boomers, it was a few decades that defined them. In fact, the term generation used to define the span of time from birth to when you had children of your own. If we take that definition today, it means 30 years because that's the peak fertility age in Australia and around the developed world. And so it's changed. A generation is a 15-year time span. It's a set segment. It's a set cohort now. And so from the baby boomers born in the post-World War II baby boom years to Generation X, we're now dealing with Generation Y and Generation Z. Generation Y are those born between 1980 and 1994. And Generation Z are those born from 1995 through to 2009. These generations are not just young and emerging generations, they are significant and influential generations. If you add up the Gen Ys and the Gen Zs in our world today, we're talking about more than 3 billion people. We're talking about almost half the population of the planet. And just from Australia's perspective, we're talking about 41%. Of our national population, so pretty sizable generations, and they have an impact even above their demographic weight. They are not just young people anymore. Take Generation Y, they're sometimes called the millennials, but they're not the youth generation anymore. They're in their early 30s at the oldest edge, and so they're the family formers, they're the emerging leaders, they're the generation of employees moving up through the ranks, they're the influencers in our society, they're the wealth accumulators, and they're spending more than they ever have in the past. And Generation Z, coming fast behind them, are at the moment the children and teenagers, but they're fast approaching their 20-something years as well. And while today they're all students, by the end of this decade, they'll comprise more than 1 in 10 workers, and so they're moving into those employment years as well. Getting an understanding of these new generations is obviously critical for us. In just their span of living, we've seen society change from an era of traditional media to this world of social media. Leadership has changed from a bit more authoritarian and coordinating to now more inspiring and engaging. We've seen a shift in communication, even educational principles, from very structural and auditory to now very engaging and visual and multimodal and hands-on. A shift in leadership and influencing them, from the experts being those that were older and had the experience, to now the peer groups influencing them, and the power of the social validation online really influencing choices. Brands have shifted from almost an anti-brand era a generation ago to now this era of brand evangelism, where people say, hey, this is the brand that I love, what do you think, and share that amongst their social network. Global generations, not just locally defined ones. So massive changes we've seen with the 21st century generations, Generations Y and Z. I've written a whole book about the generations, the global generations, called The ABC of XYZ, and there are free chapters online. And you'll also find a generational profile where you can look at some more demographics about these generations globally. But if you want to know what comes after Generation X and Generation Y and Generation Z, it's Generation Alpha. That generation born since 2010, they'll be not only the largest generation our world has ever seen and the most technologically savvy, but the most globally connected and the most influential as well. So getting a handle on Generation Alpha will be important for us all as well.